You know, it's hard to believe that it has been 20 years since the terrorist attacks of 9/11. There are likely to be many tributes due to that milestone anniversary. One was to take place here in Las Vegas on March 23rd. It promised to be very moving, literally and emotionally.
This September marks 20 years since the World Trade Center and the Pentagon were struck by passenger jets flown by terrorists. And a third jet went down in Pennsylvania when passengers fought back and forced the plane into the ground. We vowed never to forget, but who would have ever thought this semi would be carrying a tribute built by someone who does not even live in this country and was only 3 months old the day of the attack. Don Vanderstein lives in the Netherlands and is from a family of firefighters. So although he was only an infant when this happened, as he grew older, he became more and more moved by the countless people lost as a result of the senseless attack. He decided to pay tribute to the first responders and all those killed by building a replica of the World Trade Center. He put 10,000 hours into the project.
Amazing young man. The plan is we will actually have him over here when we go to Manhattan.
Cody Cross is responsible for transporting the replica in this truck, stopping in 21 cities as he makes his way east to New York City and Ground Zero. Las Vegas is his fourth stop.
From here, we go to Phoenix and other points east, and we will actually be taking this truck and the exhibit to the Flight 93 Memorial in Shanksville, Pennsylvania. We'll also be going to Arlington National Cemetery, the Pentagon, and then finally we'll be headed into Manhattan with it for the 20th anniversary of 9/11.
As you can see, the truck is more than a vessel. It is in itself a tribute to the fallen, to the military who continue to fight global terrorism every day, the firefighters, police, and medical personnel. This engine painted on the truck carried firefighters to the scene. They never returned to their fire station.
The engine that is depicted on the truck is actually from Midtown Fire Station. And that engine, every firefighter that was assigned to that company and that firehouse was killed on 9/11. If you look closely at the picture, you can actually see the operators of the engine, the engineer, the firefighters, the company is in the engine. And when you see that, and then the realization comes that obviously that picture was taken pre-9/11, to know that those individuals are no longer with us, it just, to me, it changes things.
The truck parked overnight at Las Vegas Fire and Rescue Station 1 the day before it would take part in an honor walk at the Grant Sawyer Building. Little did we know, the walk would never take place.
Can we have everybody please stand and walk over to this side for us, please?
Just a few feet behind the line of cameras, this was the culprit. What appeared to be a series of stripped batteries connected to wire. With its placement so close to the Memorial Park on a day when it was known many people were going to be here for a ceremony, it was declared a possible explosive device. And to be safe, the area around the park and the Grant Sawyer Building were cleared. The bomb squad, Metro Police, Las Vegas Fire and Rescue, and bomb-sniffing dogs were brought in immediately. It was eventually determined to be harmless, and the okay was given for everyone to return. It is still a mystery as to what the device is and why it was there, but by the time the area was opened back up, the skies opened up as well, and the 9/11 tribute was forced to be canceled.
Fortunately, there was no incident and no one was injured, but a big hats off to the bomb squad, Las Vegas Fire and Rescue, Metro, and all first responders who showed up so quickly to make sure that we were all safe. Well, after that eventful day, that truck took off for the highway, stopping in 17 more cities before finally stopping in New York City and Ground Zero, where the replica will remain.